Jenny Peace Corps.
This the real world, homie, school's finished. They just stole your dreams, you don't know who did it. I treat the cash the way the government treat AIDS. I won't be satisfied till all my niggas get it. Is hip-hop just a euphemism for a new religion? The soul music of the slaves that the youth is missing. But this is more than just my road to redemption. Malcolm West had the whole nation standing at attention. As long as I'm in polo smiling, they think they got me. But they'll try to crack me if they ever see a black me.
Ultralight beam, we on a ultralight beam. This is a God dream, this is a God dream. This is everything. This is everything. Deliver us serenity, deliver us peace, deliver us love, and we know we need it. You know we need it. You know we need it. Then why we need you now? Oh, pray for Paris. Pray for the parents. This is a God dream. This is a God dream. This is a God dream. We on a ultralight beam. We on a ultralight beam. This is a God dream. This is a God dream. This is everything.
Siente 26.9.29 semicolon 74 semicolon 3 nu 11. Namaste, assalamu alaikum, shalom, mir, ni hao, buenos dias, hisache, akwaba, velkomin. What up though? We have a deen today. We are in peace and joy to join with you today in what will go down in history as the greatest demonstration for happiness and liberation in the history of our earth. Inshallah, Bezrat Hashem, God willing, Jai Om. 50 years ago, a great human being in whose ideological shadow we stand built the Ahimsa Satyagraha. This momentous endeavor came as a great beacon light of inspiration to billions of human slaves who had been seared in the flames of withering greed, hatred, and delusion. It came as a tranquil daybreak to end the long night of captivity. But 100 years later, the human being still is not happy and liberated. 100 years later, the life of the human being is still sadly crippled by the manacles of violence and the chains of indentured servitude. 100 years later, the human being lives on a lonely island of selfishness in the midst of a vast ocean of technological opportunity. 100 years later, the human being is still languished in the corners of human society and finds himself an exile in his own land. And so we've come here today to dramatize a shameful condition. In a sense, we've come to our Earth's center to cash a check. When the architects of our human civilization shared the magnificent words of Torah, Bhagavad Gita, Digha Nikaya, Dhammapada, Gospels, Quran, Tao Te Ching, and our additional holy scriptures of earth, they were completing a promissory note to which every human being was to fall heir. This note was a promise that all human beings, yes, high priest, and outcast, are entitled to genuine support towards happiness and liberation. Guided within an ethical discipline of honesty, sobriety, veganism, marital fidelity, ethical economics. It is obvious today that humanity has defaulted on this promissory note, in so much as all human beings are concerned. Instead of honoring this sacred obligation, humanity has given all human beings a bad check, a check which has come back marked insufficient funds. We believe the bank of karma is plentiful. We believe there is tremendous account within the constitution of this earth. So we've come to cash this check, a check that will give us upon demand the treasures of happiness and liberation. We have also come to this holy center to remind humanity of the fierce urgency of now. This is no time to engage in the luxury of cooling off or taking the tranquilizing drug of gradualism. Now is the time to make true the proclamations of diversity and multiculturalism. Now is the time to rise from the dark and desolate valley of indulgence to the sunlit path of pluralism. Now is the time to lift our earth from the quicksands of greed, hatred, and delusion to the solid rock of ethical discipline. Now is the time to invest in happiness and liberation as a reality for all of God's children. It would be catastrophic for humanity to overlook the urgency of the moment. This diseased season of the human being's self-infection will not pass until there is an invigorating wind of wisdom and righteousness. This 126 year after the parliament of the world's religions is not an end, but a beginning. Those who hope that the human being needed to blow off steam and will now be harmonious and productive will have a rude awakening if humanity returns to business as usual. There will be neither rest nor tranquility in humanity until the human being is supported in his sacred purpose. The whirlwinds of disease will continue to shake the foundations of humanity until the bright day of happiness and liberation emerges. But there is something that I must say to my people, who stand on the worn threshold which leads into the palace of happiness and liberation. In the process of gaining our dutiful place, we must not be guilty of wrongful deeds. Let us not seek to satisfy our thirst for happiness and liberation by drinking from the cup of predators or prey, of greed, hatred, or delusion. We must forever conduct our upliftment, our daily behavior of actions, communications, and thoughts on the high plane of dignity and discipline, wisdom and righteousness. We must not allow our creative productivity to degenerate into violence, indulgence, or exploitation. Again and again, we must rise to the majestic heights of meeting physical force with soul force. The marvelous new militancy which has engulfed the human being community must not lead us to distrust our oppressive people. For many of our oppressive brothers, as evidenced by their presence here today, have come to recognize their destiny is bonded with our destiny. They have come to recognize that their happiness and liberation lives within inextricable relationship with our happiness and liberation. We cannot walk alone, and as we walk, we must make the pledge that we shall always march ahead. We cannot turn back. There are those who are asking the practitioners of ethical discipline, when will you be satisfied? We can never be satisfied until the human being is safe from the unspeakable horrors of police brutality, sexual exploitation, and psychiatric detention. We can never be satisfied until municipal bodies, heavy with the fatigue of daily travail, gain clean, healthy air, clean, healthy rain, streams, lakes, and oceans, clean, healthy soil, plants, trees, and produce, clean, healthy insects, animals, and people, all our relations. We cannot be satisfied until the human being is politically self-determinant and economically just, fair, cooperative, and balanced, with efficient, comfortable homes, efficient, comfortable health, family, and social services, efficient, comfortable utilities and infrastructure, efficient, comfortable public and global transportation. We can never be satisfied until our children are bestowed with honest schools that teach knowledge of self, discipline of self, love of self, with books, curricula, and media that share our ancient wisdom of songs, stories, rituals, and our ancient righteousness of ethical discipline. We can never be satisfied until rezes and native lands are returned as native sovereignties with native traditions and healthy relationship with Inamaka. No, we are not satisfied, and we will not be satisfied until love, peace, and justice roll down like waters and wisdom and righteousness like a mighty stream. We are not unmindful that some of you have come here out of great trials and tribulations. Some of you have come fresh from narrow jail cells, isolated within psychiatric wards, shackled in the spiraling refuge of intoxication, enveloped within the guilt-ridden self-afflictions of obesity, masturbation, and overconsumption, riddled by the incessance of suspicion, anxiety, depression, apathy, anger, fear, hopelessness, and betrayal. Some of you have come from areas where your quest for happiness and liberation left you battered by the storm of persecution and staggered by the winds of police, financial, medical, and sexual brutality. You have been the veterans of creative suffering. Let's continue to walk with the faith and discipline that all suffering is redemptive. Let's go back to Hiroshima. Let's go back to the Atlantic Ocean. Let's go back to Cambodia. Let's go back to Auschwitz. Let's go back to Sierra Leone. Let's go back to Serbia. Let's go back to native land. Let's go back to the snowflake laboratories, knowing that somehow the situation can and will change. Let us not wallow in the valley of despair. We say to you today, my holy brethren, that in spite of the difficulties, frustrations, and temptations of the moment, we still have a Deen. It is a Deen deeply rooted in the Deen of Holy Earth. We have a Deen that with today, this humanity rises up and lives out the true meaning of its creed, that recognition of the inherent dignity and of the equal and inalienable rights of all members of the human family is the foundation of liberation, justice, peace, and happiness in the world. We have a Deen that with today, in the metropolises around Hiroshima, the sons of former criminals and the sons of former debt mongers are able to sit down together at a table of brotherhood. We have a Deen that with today, the shores of the Atlantic Ocean, a vast expanse swollen with corpses of injustice, swollen with corpses of oppression, are transformed into a sanctuary of happiness and liberation. We have a Deen that our little children, born and yet born, with today, live on an earth where they are not condemned by the color of their skin, but supported through the content of their character. We have a Deen today. We have a Deen that with today, down in Cambodia, Auschwitz, Sierra Leone, and Serbia, places with vicious legacies, with General Assembly governors having lips dripping with the words of interposition and nullifications, today right there in Cambodia, Auschwitz, Sierra Leone, and Serbia, little Buddhist boys and little Israeli girls are able to join hands with little Wolof boys and little Slavic girls as brothers and sisters. We have a Deen today. We have a Deen that with today, both native land and the orphan return. Every valley is exalted, every hill and mountain is made low, the rough places are made plain, and the crooked places are made straight, and the glory of the Lord is revealed, and all flesh sees it together. This is our work. This is the faith and discipline that I go back home to the hood, to the village with. With this faith and discipline, we are able to hew out of the mountain of despair a stone of determination. With this faith and discipline, we are able to transform the jangling discords of our humanity into a beautiful symphony of brotherhood. With this faith and discipline, we are able to work together, to pray, meditate, and study together, to strive together, to go beyond lockups and lockdowns together, to stand up for happiness and liberation together, knowing that we are happy and liberated today. This is the day. This is the day when all God's children are able to sing with full meaning, one love, one heart. Let's get together and feel all right. Give thanks and praise to the Lord, and I will feel all right. And if humanity is to be a great civilization, this must become true. And thus, let happiness and liberation lovingly flow amidst the northern lights of the Ob Yenisei, Lena, and Amur rivers. Let happiness and liberation lovingly flow amidst the swaying bamboo of the Huang Yangtze and Mekong rivers. Let happiness and liberation lovingly flow amidst the pilgrimages of the Ganges and Indus rivers. Let happiness and liberation lovingly flow amidst the sacred banks of the Tigris, Euphrates, and Jordan rivers. Let happiness and liberation lovingly flow amidst the steppes of the Volga and Danube rivers. Let happiness and liberation lovingly flow amidst the strength of the Rhine River. Let happiness and liberation lovingly flow amidst the stretch of the Nile River. Let happiness and liberation lovingly flow amidst the cascades of the Zambezi River. Let happiness and liberation lovingly flow amidst the lullaby of the Congo River. Let happiness and liberation lovingly flow amidst the independence of the Tui Ebo River. But not only that. Let happiness and liberation lovingly flow amidst the forests of the Guarani and Inca rivers. Let happiness and liberation lovingly flow amidst the many vines of the Yanomami River. Let happiness and liberation lovingly flow amidst the hospitality of the Navajo and Hopi rivers. Let happiness and liberation lovingly flow amidst the redwoods of the Ute River. Let happiness and liberation lovingly flow amidst the domes of the Aleut and Inuit rivers. Let happiness and liberation lovingly flow amidst the Tatanka plains of the Mississippi River. Let happiness and liberation lovingly flow amidst the gatherings of the Haudenosaunee-Algonquin River. And when this happens, when we allow happiness and liberation to lovingly flow, when we let it lovingly flow from every village and every favela, shantytown, bush, cul-de-sac, gated community, and hamlet, from every state, province, city, barrio, quartier, and township, we strengthen this day when all of God's children, Brahmin and Dalit, Israeli and Native, Muslim and Taoist, are able to join hands and sing in the words of the ancient spiritual. Shalom. 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 Namaste, assalamu alaikum, shalom, mir, zaijin, adios, te chakris, esempina asamugo, kele ufred, one love and peace, happiness and liberation.